quite from a musical family, and your sister's in a band. So, I mean, give them a plug. Get the City fans listening to them.
Yeah, so they're called Wildwood Kin. Go and check them out. I don't know how to describe their music, but they're sort of Americana, indie kind of. They're not too poppy, but it's a good listen. They're a massive support for things like mental health. They support that massively. But it would really help them out because of obviously COVID. Things like income for them has been a huge struggle. So it would massively help them out if people could go and, I don't know, buy their album, or they've got a live session coming up in the next few months where people can tune in. So some of the fans could tune into that and support them. That would help them and help me out a lot.
We will make sure that we post about that on our social media if we can.
Thank you.
So staying on the music theme, who's your favourite artist at the moment?
I like a lot of 80s stuff. That's my problem. I like old music, but
don't we all?
Yeah. My go-to is always Stevie Wonder. I love Stevie Wonder, so that'll be that one.
And we've been hearing from a lot of the lads that you've got a fairly good voice. And I know you've said before we started this that you won't sing for us, but what's your go-to song?
I mean, on my initiation, as I said, I sung You Give Me Something by James Morrison, because I thought, yeah, it suits my voice a bit. But yeah, that's probably my go-to sing-song. That'd be it.
So from music to football then, which is obviously easiest for you to talk about. Growing up, who was your inspiration as a footballer? Who did you look up to?
Looked up to Ryan Giggs. Been a fan of Man United. My dad was a George Best fan, so he supported Man United. The Fergie era. Ryan Giggs was my favourite. And he managed to watch us play against Salford, so that was a good experience.
Having him watch you must have been amazing. Yeah.
So yeah.
What about in the team? Who's your best friend?
It'd be Kite, Harry Kite. We do a lot of stuff together. So, it'd be Kitey.
On to some more of the more random ones now. What's your go-to food if you were to cook for someone or to cook for yourself? What do you usually make?
I mean, I'm not the best cook. But I think my go-to would just be something like a pasta bake. You can't beat pasta. It's an elite sort of food, really.
Tea or coffee?
Coffee, yeah, coffee. Love a coffee.
Cats or dogs?
Dogs all day.
Are you much of a reader? Do you have a favourite book?
Not a huge reader, but nah, I couldn't think of any off my head.
I put some of these questions to the girls, and one of the girls in the office, and she said she wants to know, what's your favourite sandwich?
That's a good question, actually. You know what, my go-to, it's pretty boring, but it's just ham and coleslaw, or cheese and pickle, actually. Yeah.
And I think we're all in need of a holiday after this year. Where's your favourite holiday destination, or your dream destination?
My dream destination for a holiday would be Fiji.
Why not?
Just it looks really nice.
And what about where you've already been? Where's the best place you've been?
It's a weird one, but I actually I went to Israel once, and I mean, I think social media doesn't do it too much justice, but some of the landscapes and sort of things you find there is amazing. It was so hot. I'm not very good with heat, but yeah.
I've heard Tel Aviv's a bit of a party city as well. So
yeah.
Maybe that can go on the list for one day for me.
Yeah, maybe.
That's all of them, mate.
Is it? Cool.
Thank you so much.